The Godfather is a 1972 American crime film directed by Francis Ford Coppola, based on Mario Puzo's best-selling novel of the same name. It is the first installment of the Godfather trilogy. It stars Marlon Brando and Al Pacino as the father and son of a fictional New York crime family. The story, spanning 1945 to 1955, chronicles the family under the patriarch Vito Corleone, focusing on the transformation of the son, Michael Corleone, raised to have a life outside of crime, from a reluctant family outsider to ruthless mafia boss. Today we bring you 10 facts you didn't know about The Godfather. Welcome to the Life Television. Tell them, KK.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Number 10, Francis Ford Coppola was almost fired. Francis Ford Coppola, who got the movie because of his previous movie, The Rain People, wasn't the first director Paramount Pictures had in mind for The Godfather. Alia Kazan, Arthur Penn, Richard Brooks, and Kosta Gavras also turned the job down. And after filming began, executives didn't like the brooding, talky drama that Coppola was shooting, even going so far as to have stand-in directors waiting on set. Coppola was reportedly getting the axe until he shot the scene where Michael kills Sollozzo, which the executives saw and loved. Number 9. Coppola fought to keep the logo. The studio originally wanted to scrap the now iconic Puppet Strings logo. Coppola insisted on keeping Puzo's name in the logo because Puzo co-wrote the script with him. Number 8. Coppola fought to keep the story a period drama. As a cost-cutting measure, Paramount asked Coppola to modernize the script so the action took place in 1972 and to shoot the movie in Kansas City as a stand-in for the more expensive New York City. Coppola convinced them to keep the story in a post-World War II New York setting to maintain the integrity of the film. Number 7. Family dinners helped the cast. Coppola held improvisational rehearsal sessions that simply consisted of the main cast sitting down in character for a family meal. The actors couldn't break character, which Coppola saw as a way for the cast to organically establish the family roles seen in the final film. Number 6. Paramount didn't want Marlon Brando for the role. When Coppola initially mentioned Brando as a possibility for Vito Corleone, the head of Paramount told Coppola the actor would never appear in a Paramount picture. The studio pushed the director to cast Laurence Olivier as Vito before eventually agreeing to pursue Brando under three stringent conditions. 1. Brando had to do a screen test. 2. If cast, Brando would have to do the movie for free. 3. Brando would have to personally put up a bond to make up for all the potential losses caused by his infamously bad on-set behavior. Coppola surreptitiously lured the famously cagey Brando into what he called a makeup test, which in reality was a screen test the studio demanded. When Coppola showed the studio the test, they liked it so much they dropped the second and third stipulations and agreed to let Brando be in the movie. Number 5. Pacino wasn't the first choice to play Michael. The studio wanted Robert Redford or Ryan O'Neal to play Michael Corleone, but Coppola always wanted Al Pacino. Other actors like Martin Sheen and James Caan would go on to play Sonny, screen tested for Michael also. Number 4. Robert De Niro auditioned for Sonny. Robert De Niro auditioned for the role of Sonny, but Coppola thought his personality was too violent for the role. De Niro would later appear as a young Vito Corleone in Godfather Part 2 and win a Best Supporting Actor Oscar for his work. Number 3. Coppola let the wedding play out and shot it guerrilla style. To add a sense of reality to the wedding scene, and because he only had 2 days to shoot it, Coppola had the cast freely act out and improvise in the background. He then shot specific vignettes amongst the action. Number 2. The Corleone compound is a real location in Staten Island. The famous residence was put up for sale in 2014 for just under $3 million. Number 1. The Godfather cat was a stray. During his daily walks to set, Coppola would often see a stray cat, and on the day of shooting the scene in Vito's study, Coppola took the cat and told Brando to improvise with it. The cat loved Brando so much that it sat in his lap during takes for the whole day. It's hard to measure the cultural impact of The Godfather. From the performances, to the characters, the music, the direction, the cinematography, all made this film a classic.